got camp spot north of Eucla, not far from Weebubbie Cave again. And it's a big gravel crushing place. Quarry and KOA to the probably lived here for while they were fixing up the Eyre Highway. We got up this morning at either 4 o'clock or 7 o'clock. 4:30 or 7. We're going on to Adelaide time now. And the sun's just come out. It's blowed a little bit through the clouds. Sunrise. Now it's come out again. And there's barbecues, pit roasts and all sorts of things. And we'll be here for 1,000 years. Yeah, the sun has come out. Beautifully now. That's west where the track goes to have the curry cave. This is one of the acacias that we looked at as we drove along towards Eucla. Glistening silvery in the breeze. And we have to camp under one. They're one of the very hard wooden timbers that are protected out here. We're going to head off down to the Eyre Telegraph Station and check out the jetty. There's the microwave tower on the way into the Weebubbie Cave from the southern end. There's the telegraph station amongst the dunes and tree. And the motel up the top. There's towers over here. Height that we climbed up. Looks like it's long gone. We all walked down here on the 63-64 Nullarbor expedition. And I got the slide of Jane and Alison underneath the jetty. And then we came down with Mad Dog and John Dunkley. And got the photo of John running across the beach down to the ocean. Nothing on. Here's the old water pipe that either went or came back to the beach. There's the old windmill. There's the old windmill looking back towards the cliffs. Must have been a pup here for 100 years. Yeah, you could make some a nice mosaic out of the fragments. Any good bits gone. It's all sandblasted.
Just incredible. That's just one I can reach.
Starts. Looks like someone's driven down today. So the tide's still coming in. March flies are pretty fierce. Biking while we take photographs. It's actually quite nice in. We could keep taking photographs all day and today. Every time you stand still, they're attacked by mite flies. One of two last telegraph poles just nearby, one behind me, for some reason going through the dunes. Back on it. Another MLA deputy leaves his mark. There's the Western Australian border. Back over there somewhere. Up in the sand actually, and KOA telegraph station is down over there. Thank you. lot of tourists. This is an unnamed, just a track going in past the Starling Trap. It's 80 or 90 k west of Nullarbor. This is why some of them aren't open to the public generally. More stable.
Yeah, see what you were standing on?
Yeah, pretty rotten stuff. We've got a big wave coming now, look. Gonna make the cliffs cave in there.
Doing it for a long time, I'd say.
Yeah, the wave is going out, you wouldn't stand a chance there. Yeah, you get swept back and hit another wave coming in. This is
a
calm day. Here come the two big ones, see? Wow, look at those. Might have got that seagull too. Feels like it's gonna crash underneath us. Oh, you surfed in on that one. That broke. Yeah. that it's smashing high up all along there.
Just left Nullarbor. I've got 293 k's to the fruit inspection. And that's Nullarbor. There's the homestead over there. This is going through Yalata Aboriginal land. 1979, the Aborigines were blockading here. That's really nice camping ground. Sorry?
No, they're starting again.
Okay, I've started again. Turn off. There was a fairly major looking road that went up and it went to Ooldea. Don't know what this is. That actually might be, that's the Yalata. Oh, I don't know. I'll have to look it up and see. Well, it probably is grazing. It's got fences like grazing. We passed the dog fence back there.
Just wondering what it's equivalent to in WA, like distance from Adelaide.
Well, that doesn't say anything about what those buildings were. That we're just about out of the Yalata Reserve.
Oh, that's around the road.
So this is still Aboriginal Reserve.
All the way up to the trans line.
Yeah.
Between here and there.
Between here and all there. I don't know what this sign is. There's a fairly substantial fence over there too. It's not a dog fence, but it's a...
It's like
good fence.
Balladonia from Dawesville.
Yeah. There's the plains up north. Goes all the way up there, probably about 130 k's to the trans line, it looks like. And we just came out of the Aboriginal Reserve, so this is all farming land, I think. Farms about 3-4k back. Now it's big farms, they're all woods, lots of birds. Madura Caravan Park. It's like the first civilised sort of place since where? Quite good. Oh. built by the same people who built Nullarbor golf course.
Fowlers Bay Caravan Park. Been up for half an hour and had a cup of tea. Yeah, that's improved the view 100%. I'll have to stay a week to read all these. Said he was re-decked in 2002. Auctioned off the Jarrah decking. Raised 10,000. Put in solar lights. There used to be quite a whaling industry here. It's called Yallata Homestead. They had several outstations. It's quite a industry and property. Photograph of all the signs so we can read it when we get home. We caught something out there. Some of the whales stayed for several months. Some of them just for a few days up to October. We've got a photo somewhere that kids all jumping on this seaweed. It was in the 80s, 87 trip across in the Holden. Well, it was 1979 we frolicked in the seaweed. Not sure if anyone had the time to climb up the dunes. It's a very historic place where Edward John Eyre headed off. It was called Yallata then.
Smoky to Smoky Bay.
Well, the owner of the general store has just retired here from Adelaide and he'll pay his house off soon. Couldn't refuse for his loo paper. And there's cheaper petrol here than 70k away in Tijuana. And it was $1.56 this time last year.
Filling up at Penong, we won't get $499 or $997
or whatever.
Good, thanks. What's that? Aug is going to Woomba via Burke and Oaken Hill. $500 per side fuel. Lovely clean oiled historic windmill. An underground tank. See if we can find some shade here.
just a few kilometres east of Penong. Stop for lunch.
They used to charge for the water, the camels and horses and sheep. It used to flow in from the roof and from the channels in the neighbourhood. We'll go somewhere else for lunch. We're back at Sejuna. Can't remember whether we've got a photo and a video of this from last time, a year ago. Just spoke to Jill. Josh is on his way out next March. So that's all good news. Well, here's Smoky at Smoky Bay. They've got a long jetty as well. Lovely spot at Streaky Bay. That's a lovely view of Streaky Bay. The trouble is with a lot of dumbly designed caravan parks, they put boring Jayco boxes in front of the view. And the people who appreciate the view are in tents and caravans. Or mainly tents and campers. These people are sitting indoors with the aircon on, with no windows facing the view.